This is KGO and KGO-FM in San Francisco. Presenting now, Jude Martin's Sunrise Roundup.
Timber, all the mountains high.
Good morning out there. This is Dude Martin speaking, and here comes your sunrise roundup. 30 minutes loaded with Western music, a little bit of weather, smiddling the news, the correct time, and anything else we can think of to throw in there. Now, we'll be looking for you here for the next half hour.
I am the sky above, the love song of the trees will blend. It's way out on the breeze, tall timbers calling, and the echoes ring. For all nature sings a song along the timber trail.
Well, now, that time is 16 minutes and 20 seconds after 6 o'clock, mighty early in the morning. So I had a new experience this morning. First time I ever changed a tire at 5 o'clock in darkness. Yes, sir. Wonderful way to start the day off. Got a brand new record here. One that Brother Gene Autry just came out with. It's one of his very freshest. It's called Loaded Pistol, Loaded Dice. Let's listen, huh?
Loaded pistols and loaded dice, take my warning or pay the price, 'cause it ain't healthy to try it twice. Loaded pistols and loaded dice. Now Trigger Johnson was a gambling cub who went and joined the Western Social Club, where shooting dice was everybody's whim. It seems they favored everyone but him. The sharpies, they were taking him for fair. He said, I'm wise, this game ain't on the square. I mean, them loaded dice ain't gonna do, 'cause I've got something here that's loaded too. Loaded pistols and loaded dice, take my warning or pay the price, 'cause it ain't healthy to try it twice. Loaded pistols and loaded dice. Now this kept going on for quite a while. They made an awful dent in Trigger's pile. He reached down in his boot and got a 10, and then he shot the 10 and lost again. He stopped the game and said, I'm country fied, but still I know you took me for a ride. I also know the rules are plainly writ, but I'm about to change them up a bit. Loaded pistols and loaded dice, take my warning or pay the price, 'cause it ain't healthy to try it twice. Loaded pistols and loaded dice. Then Trigger said, it's time for me to go, but first I'm gonna take back all my dough. I want you one and all to understand, this ain't no water pistol in my hand. I'll pass my hat and you'll know what to do. I want that money back I lost to you. Before I go, I'll leave you this advice. You can't beat a loaded pistol with loaded dice. Loaded pistols and loaded dice. Take my warning, I pay the price, cause it ain't healthy to try it twice. Loaded pistols and loaded dice.
Well, in just 5 seconds, that time's going to be 20 minutes after six. Ed, I guess you got the old coffee pot on the stove. What do you say you and I just sit down right here and now and pour ourselves a nice friendly cup of coffee and look over the news which they just brought in to me? One thing that we're all interested in nowadays, whether we live in the city or on the farm or in between, weather. I can tell you one thing. Right around the Bay Area, it's mighty windy and mighty cold right about now. At least changing a front tire on a car, it's that way. The weather forecast, official that is, says that San Francisco and the Bay Area is going to be fair tonight. And Thursday and Friday, a continued cool, moderate to fresh northwesterly wind today. And let's see, Northern California will be clear tonight and Thursday. And a little temperature change, fresh northerly winds along the coast today. Up in the Sierra Nevadas, it'll be generally clear tonight and today and Thursday. Continued cold, fresh northeasterly wind through the passes. Sacramento Valley, it'll be clear today, tonight, and Thursday. Colder tonight, little temperature change Thursday. And the high today will be from 47 to 53. Low tonight, 32 to 36. The San Joaquin Valley, along with the Santa Clara, Livermore, and Salinas, all got about the same kind of weather. Clear tonight, today, Thursday, colder tonight and Thursday. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're going to have much more of that needed rain in some of the places where it's needed most. And right around the Bay Area, why, it ought to be good golfing weather for city folks. Daylight saving time, which the cows and the chickens are said to have up-to-date ignored, is back in the news again. Leaders in business and agriculture from northern and central California have gone on record favoring a temporary daylight saving in California. At least from March until November 1st, the Pacific Gas and Electric Company spokesman said that the program is needed to counteract the power shortage. Looking over those world headlines, which you'll get all the dope on if you tune right along with us till Tony Morse comes on at 6:45 this morning. Farm bloc members of Congress are getting worried over the continued slump in the commodity market. They're renewing interest in a farm price support program, although they admit that prices are still above the support level. And there's a little item here that says Democratic Senator O'Mahony of Wyoming and auto workers President Walter Reuther say that the current market fluctuations are just flutters, not the beginning of any real deflation. Republican Senator Martin of Pennsylvania claims that American foreign aid, past, present, and future, is costing more than $1,200 per American family. And from over in Yugoslavia, why, has come a demand that the United States turn over from 60 to $70 million in gold frozen during the war. Well, I think that's about enough news for now. I think it'd be... That coffee tastes wonderful at this hour of the morning, you know. I think it'd be a good time right now to get another of these records rolling. First, your time. It's 23 and a half minutes after 6. And there's a customer that tunes in every morning up in Windsor that likes a tune called Have I Told You Lately That I Love You? It's the Sons of the Pioneers on this one.
Have I told with all my heart and soul how
Well, here's that time. It's 26 minutes and 25 seconds after 6 o'clock. In case you haven't got around to that little chore of rolling out, now is the time. We've had a lot of very nice letters about our cowboy camp meeting song that we play each morning. And we've had a number of suggestions from you good friends out there that we might slip in T. Texas Tyler's recitation in that spot of a morning. His recitation of a little thing called a deck of cards. So we'll let T. Texas Tyler take over from here.
Friends, this is T. Texas Tyler with a strange story about a soldier boy and a deck of cards. During the North African campaign, a bunch of soldier boys had been on a long hike, and they arrived in a little town called Casino. The next morning being Sunday, several of the boys went to church. A sergeant commanded the boys in church, and after the chaplain had read the prayer, the text was taken up next. Those of the boys who had a prayer book took them out. But this one boy had only a deck of cards, and so he spread them out. The sergeant saw the cards and said, "Soldier, put away those cards." After the services was over, the soldier was taken prisoner and brought before the provost marshal. The marshal said, "Sergeant, why have you brought this man here?" "For playing cards in church, sir. And what have you to say for yourself, son?" "Much, sir," replied the soldier. The marshal said, "I hope so, for if not, I shall punish you more than any man was ever punished." The soldier said, "Sir, I've been on the march for about 6 days. I had neither Bible nor prayer book, but I hope to satisfy you, sir, with the purity of my intentions." With that, the boy started his story. "You see, sir, when I look at the ace, it reminds me that there is but one God. And the deuce reminds me that the Bible is divided into two parts, the Old and the New Testament. And when I see the tray, I think of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And when I see the four, I think of the four evangelists who preached the gospel. There was Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And when I see the five, it reminds me of the five wise virgins who trimmed their lamps. There were 10 of them. 5 were wise and were saved. 5 were foolish and were shut out. And when I see the 6, it reminds me that in 6 days God made this great heaven and earth. When I see the 7, it reminds me that on the 7th day, God rested from his great work. And when I see the 8, I think of the 8 righteous persons God saved when he destroyed this earth. There was Noah, his wife, their 3 sons, and their wives. And when I see the 9, I think of the lepers our Savior cleansed, and 9 out of the 10 didn't even thank him. When I see the 10, I think of the 10 commandments God handed down to Moses on a table of stone. When I see the king, it reminds me there's but one king of heaven, God Almighty. And when I see the queen, I think of the blessed Virgin Mary, who is queen of heaven, and the jack or knave is the devil. When I count the number of spots on a deck of cards, I find 365, the number of days in a year. There's 52 cards, the number of weeks in a year. There's 4 suits, the number of weeks in a month. There's 12 picture cards, the number of months in a year. There's 13 tricks, the number of weeks in a quarter. So you see, sir, my pack of cards serves me as a Bible, almanac, and prayer book. And friends, this story's true. I know because I was that soldier.
Well, now your time is 6:30 and 15 seconds, and this is that sunrise roundup. This is Dude Martin doing the yakety-yakking here, and we come rolling out your way from 6:15 to 6:45, Monday through Friday. Every morning with your favorite Western tunes. It's your request that we like to play, so don't you be bashful about dropping a line to Dude Martin, care of KGO in San Francisco, and telling us what that favorite record of yours is. If we haven't got it, we'll get it. Yes, sir. We have a very good friend over in San Leandro that likes a tune called The Best Deal in Town. It's one of Spade Cooley's very latest, so let's give that one a listen, huh?
the best deal in town. I don't have to look around. Got a gal, and what a gal is she. I've got the best deal in town. Blackest hair and eyes of brown. All the other fellows envy me. And on the beach each summer, she's so easy on the eyes. She's got the brand of figure that it pays to advertise. When it's all said and done, men prefer her 2-1. I'm sure I've got the best deal in town. And a $1 million smile. And for her brand of kisses, I would gladly walk a mile. And on our wedding day, why, the preacher man will say, my boy, you've got the best deal in town.
Well, your time lacks just 30 seconds of being 27 minutes to 7 o'clock. We've had some very nice letters from you friends about the little Western poems that I've been collecting for years. And there's a listener way down in Modesto that kind of likes one that they said they hadn't heard us do in many a long year. It's one that Curly Fletcher, an old friend of mine, wrote. Curly wrote the song, the Strawberry Roan and the Ridge Running Roan and some of those. He's a boy that's really lived right out there and knows what he's talking about. And the Flying Outlaw goes something like this. Come gather around me, cowboys, and listen to me close while I tell you about a Mustang that must have been a ghost. You might have heard of a cayuse in the days that they called him a steed that spent his time with the eagles and only come down for his feed. He goes by the name of Pegasus. He has himself wings to fly and eats and drinks in the Badlands, and then ranges around in the sky. Seems he belongs to an outfit, some sisters, the Muses, they say. They always kept him in hobbles till he busts them and gets away. For years, they tried hard to catch him, but he keeps right on running free. The riders wore way too much clothes then, for cowboys was knights, you see. He sure bears a bad reputation. I don't savvy just how it did begin, part eagle, part horse and the devil. It claims he's meaner than sin. Well, I'm riding that Rimrock country up there around Wild Horse Springs, and I like to fell out of my saddle when that bronc sailed in on his wings. I feels like I must be plumb crazy as I gazes over a bank a-watching that albino Mustang a-preening his wings as he drank. Finally, it fills up with water and wings folded. He starts into graze, and I notices that he's headed up my way where I straddled my horse in a daze. And then I comes to, all excited, my hands is trembling in hope, as I reaches down on my saddle and fumbles a noose in my rope. Ready, I rides right out at him, a spurring and swinging my loop, and before he can turn and get going, I throws and it fits like a hoop. I jerks out the slack and I dallies and I turn my horse and throws him neat. He lets out a blood-curdling beller while I'm hog-tying his feet. I puts my hackmore on him and a pair of blinds on his eyes, and I hobbles his wings tight together so he sure can't get back in those skies. I lets him up when he's saddled. The cinch is sunk deep in his hide, and I takes the slack out of my spur straps because it looks like a pretty tough ride. I crawls him just like he was gentle. I'm a little bit nervous, you can bet. I feels pretty sure I can ride him. I still has his wings hobbled yet. I raises the blinds, and he's snorting. Then he moves like he's walking on eggs. He grunts and explodes like a pistol, and I sees that he's at home on his legs. Why, wolves and panthers, grizzlies, centipedes, triantlers and such, scorpions, snakes, and bad whiskey compared to him wasn't much. I got a deep seat in my saddle and my spurs both bogged in the cinch. I don't aim to take any chances. I won't let him budge me an inch. He acts like he's just plumb full of loco, just ain't got a lick of sense. He's weaving and bucking so crooked that I thinks of an Arkansas fence. I'm riding my best and I'm busy, and troubled keeping my seat. He didn't need wings for flying. He's handy enough on his feet. He's got me half blind and weakening. He's bucking around in big rings, besides which he kept me a-guessing, a-ducking and dodging his wings. By golly, he starts getting rougher. He's spinning and sunfishing, too, and I grabs me both hands full of leather, and I'm weary and wishing he's through. He hits on that ground with a twister that broke the wing hobbles right there, and before I can get loose and quit him, we're sailing away in the air. He smooths out and keeps on a climb until way down miles below I gets a look at the mountains and the peaks all covered with snow. Up through the clouds I'm freezing and plumb scared and I'm dizzy to boot. I sure was wishing I had me one of them things called a pair of mashoot. And then I must have gone loco. Or maybe I go sound asleep. 'Cause when I wakes up, I'm lying right down on the ground in a heap. He may have had wings like an angel. He may have been light on his feet. But he ought to have had horns like the devil and a mouth fit for eating raw meat. I've lost a good saddle and bridle, my rope and some other good things. But boys, I'm sure glad to be here to tell you. Stay off of them horses with wings. And so goes a little Western classic by Curly Fletcher. Well, let me see here. We got a request from a listener in Oakland that sure likes the way Roy Acuff and those boys from Nashville, Tennessee, his do the old Wabash Cannonball. So, Oakland friends, coming right at you. Now, I'd better give you folks that are ready to dash out of that house the time. It's just 21 and a half minutes to 7 o'clock.
Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, from the queen of glowing mountains to the South Bell by the shore. She's mighty tall and handsome and known quite well by all. She's the combination on the Wabash Cannonball. She came down from Birmingham one cold December day. As she rolled into the station, you could hear all the people say, there's a girl from Tennessee, she's long and she's tall. She came down from Birmingham on the Wabash Cannonball. Eastern states are dandies, so the people always say, from New York to St. Louis and Chicago by the way, from the hills of Minnesota where the rippling waters fall, no changes can be taken on that Wabash Cannonball. Here's to Daddy Claxton, may his name forever stand, and always be remembered round the ports of Alabama. His earthly race is over and the curtains round him fall. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash Cannonball. the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engineer, that lonesome hobo's call. Hear traveling through the jungles on the Wabash cannonball.
Your time is 19 minutes to 7 in the morning. Well, here's an unusual little bit of fiddling. The original Arthur Smith, that is, and the Orange Blossom Special.
Look yonder coming, coming down the railroad track. Look yonder coming, coming down the railroad track. It's the orange blossom badger, bringing my baby back.
Some special we're going to have time for this morning. Your time is 17 minutes to 7. And, you know, when 6:15 rolls around tomorrow morning, if you're not there listening, I'm going to feel kind of lonesome all by myself here with my little platters. So be there listening, won't you? And you can help me to please you better and make it more fun for all of us if you'll drop me a line. Dude Martin, KGO, San Francisco. Tell me what your favorite tune is. We'll get it in here. Yes, we will. Until tomorrow, then, at the same time, it's Dude Martin saying for myself and all my little platters, thanks for listening. So long. Adios.
Timber!
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 Oh, the mountains high.
Timber!
Down the canyon wide.
Listen tomorrow at 6:15 for Dude Martin's Sunrise Roundup. This is ABC, the American Broadcasting Company.